We were going to try to do it the other way. Let's try it the other way. See if we like that. You like that any better? Wow, look at that going down there. We're ramping up here. There's a whole new dispensation. We'll see what we can do with this. Probably we'll have to bang on this with a hammer. But there is a final coda after this, and it's electronically based with backwards sounds. The Beatles had done stuff like that. And we'll see if there's any version on YouTube that offers this. I've got it from the original album, but all bets are off as to whether it is available elsewhere online.
You could say she was a sex fiend. I met her in a hotel lobby, masturbating with a magazine. She said, "How'd you like to waste some time?" And I could not resist when I saw little Nikki grind.
Erling Wold grew up in suburbia, as I did,
and found his way to the Bay Area. And we've been good friends for a number of years. He was part of the inspiration for me founding the Composer's Chamber Orchestra. He's been my right-hand person for all these years. And both of us are also, arguably, third-generation minimalists, if you take a creative generation as being a 10-year span. And since we've both been inspired by, among other people, folks like Steve Reich and Philip Glass, you hear those tendencies. Over the years, both of us have grown increasingly dissonant. Erling, by and large, I think defaults sweeter than I do, more harmonically luxurious. His melodies tend to be freer, sprung, arching, soaring melodies, and libretti that are considerably more wonderfully abstract. We tend to be kind of a concrete guy. So here we have and we'll talk about Supanci Pilato when we get where we're going. So Erling Wold's Supanci Pilato is a big spin on the Catholic Mass, specifically the Credo, specifically the line, I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. Third day he rose again from the dead. But specifically, that's Supanci Pilato, under Pontius Pilate. What happened to Pontius Pilate? The word is unclear as to his fate. Various legends have cropped up. So Erling took, with the help of his librettist, a number of the stories and, shall we say, kind of whisked them all together to make a very lyrical spin on the possibilities of Pontius Pilate. And you heard the opening, bit of a bloodbath there, literally. And then we're going to focus on, indeed, the Credo section. Ultimately, Erling took the Credo and he expanded it into a full Catholic Mass. Classic Erling, he calls it the Notker the Stammerer Mass, Missa Notker Babulus, that's Latin for saying. But here we have the initial statement of the Credo, which starts out a cappella, and like Philip Glass mid-career in a piece called Hydrogen Jukebox, here Erling is really getting away from pulse minimalism, and it's really just a beautiful a cappella rendition there. And then the pulse and the trance is reintroduced, and there's a progressive revelation, as you might have in Steve Reich. The orchestra features yours truly on the oboe. Smash success, no question. And as you can see, his staging and musicality is always top-notch. So the progressive revelation of bum, 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 builds up to, really, in the midsection, it's kind of an ABA piece, to a resounding lyrical construction. And it's kind of like that Indian classical music, increased figuration, increased dynamics, increased excitement.